great to have you back. How are you?
I'm good. How are you? I'm well. Are you good? Are you happy?
I'm very happy to have you here. You are the new boss of the Australian Pops Orchestra, and one of your first gigs, I might have given it away in the intro, is on New Year's Eve.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
It is very, very exciting. So we've got our New Year's Eve gala happening at Hamer Hall in Melbourne at the Arts Centre. And it's something that's been happening there for 20, 30 years. And so we've got our 60-piece orchestra on stage. The fabulous Harrison Craig is going to be singing, Marina Pryor and Sylvie Palladino, Australia's leading ladies of song, Dennis Walter, the magnificent baritone. So it's a really beautiful way to ring in the new year. We have a lot of regular customers who come every year and they love it. And, you know, it's just a really fabulous way to see out 2019 and get ready for 2020. That's right.
And it's a huge, spectacular venue for anyone who's been there. It's massive. It's the best in the city. Now, you work most New Year's Eve nights. Do you miss kind of not being there to pop the champagne or to, you know, kiss Meg Ryan under the mistletoe?
He says he doesn't.
People do.
Well, the interesting thing, so this, it's funny, when I was, 15, 16, 17, 18, I would work every New Year's Eve and I didn't really like it all that much. And I sort of vowed I never want to work New Year's. Once I started, you know, doing morning television all those years ago and I had sort of regular work throughout the year, I thought I'd never want to work New Year's Eve again until the Australian Pops Orchestra job came up. And I thought, this is just too good. And the thing is, we finish sort of around 10, 11 o'clock. So there's still time to go outside. It's right near where the fireworks are in Melbourne. And we're actually looking at later this week having launching a ticket where you can come along and watch the fireworks from a special viewing area as well. But we're working on that to happen later in the week to announce that. So, I actually love this gig because it's the perfect sort of time of year to be in Melbourne and to...
It's right in the heart of the city, like you said. Yeah. It's right in Federation Square and Flinders Street Station.
Exactly.
And it's where it's all happening. That's awesome.
It's the heart of it all, yeah.
The Pops Orchestra has a lot of history as well. It's performed with the likes of Luciano Pavarotti.
Never heard of him.
Well, look, Dame Kiri Takanawa, I think Andrea Bocelli's performed with the orchestra. And for people that don't know, like a Pops Orchestra is really an orchestra that plays popular music. And, you know, there's the famous Boston Pops Orchestra. It's something that happens around the world and...
Like Britney Spears and stuff?
Well, if she wants an orchestra, we are available. Yes, absolutely.
I did perform with Ray Charles one time.
Yeah, the great thing about this particular orchestra is that they're very, very versatile musicians who can play the sort of serious classical stuff but also very happy to... So, you know, Harrison Craig, for example, will be doing the Michael Bublé style of stuff, which is a bit jazzier and a bit swingier. Yeah, and then Marina Pryor will sing beautiful Broadway hits, as will Sylvie Palladino.
I think he worked with a young up-and-comer called Cliff Richard as well.
Did anything ever come of him? He's a very talented...
He's got it.
But you personally, you've obviously worked with some incredible artists, with Burt Bacharach and Tony Bennett. Is there somebody that's on your wish list? Is there somebody that you would give your right arm to work with?
Well, you know, I would love to work more with those people you just mentioned. You know, the Tony Bennett thing was a very brief encounter, which was we played one number together and that was great, but I'd love to do more with him.
Barbara.
These
Barbara
are all the
Streisand.
People we need to try and work out how to bring them down so that they can come here, talk exclusively on your show and then do a concert with the Aussie Pops Orchestra.
Yeah, John O'Coleman has a lovely singing voice, just so you know. You might want to
that'd be good. Actually, we should work on that. This is Dolly Parton. They've got the 9 to 5 show happening. We have to work out an exclusive thing. She'll come and chat to you and then do a night with the Aussie Pops Orchestra. How do we organise this?
Incredible.
Who do we talk
to? She just needs to change 9 to 5 to 7 to 11. And then
You know, you've made it when you're lampooned. Now, the folk at Full Frontal once took the mickey out of you and Dirt.
There's me.
Let's take a look.
That is like another era.
Welcome back to Good Morning Australia. Welcome back to GMA.
Did you ever mount the piano?
Not quite like that. There's Belvedere, the floor manager.
You did the big reunion, the big GMA reunion when we were in Melbourne. That was a lot of fun.
Yeah, look, I mean, it's great that you guys are carrying on the tradition of the live morning television
program. How many
years
were you on air for?
I think we were 12, 13 years on air.
Yeah.
What are you up to? You must be
getting close. Well, we're the second longest morning show, running morning show on Channel 10.
Is that because you're 5 hours a day? Is that what you mean?
No, on air continuously.
Right, so that's brilliant. Yeah.
So we've got to catch up to you guys, hopefully.
Well, that's fantastic. Yeah, how long have you been? 6 years, right.
Yeah, it only feels like 12.
Yeah, that's right. But we thought, now that you're here, we might do a little bit of reliving of the GMA days.
Oh, yes.
We have a little, look what we've a little
clue. Here's one we prepared earlier.
Look at that. I wouldn't try to straddle that one.
How would you like to do our play on an officer break?
Sure, on your magnificent grand piano.
We don't have the budget birth hat.
That's fine.
Channel 10's gone through some changes.
That's fine. Yeah, well, so long as I can play Auld Lang Syne to remind people to go to artcentremelbourne.com.au. No.
Yeah, genius. I'm going to do a double plug. If you'd like to ring it in 2020 with John, you can head to artcentremelbourne.com.au or tickettech.com.au. You're going to tickle the ivories?
Sure.
It's not quite ivory, is it?
I don't know. We don't tickle the plastic.
I can tell you, that's my keyboard, and that is top grade Chinese plastic right there.
John Foreman, everyone.
Never brought to mind.
We've checked with our lawyers. Unfortunately, we can't kidnap him. Would you put your hands together for the one, the only, John? Yeah.
Come and say goodbye.
Song you were playing. It just made me think, but what am I doing on New Year's Eve? I haven't made any plans yet. Have you got any ideas?
Why don't you come to Melbourne and spend it with the Australian Pops Orchestra at Arts Centre Melbourne, along with Sylvie Palladino, Marina Pryor, Harrison Craig, Dennis Walter, and a 60-piece orchestra.
I guess you could say I've got a prior engagement.
Whoa! Yes. That was lovely.
Thank you. John Foreman, you're welcome anytime.
Thank you very much.
Thank you
lovely
so much for dropping by.